really great to have this wonderful opportunity to address my dear fellow Nigerian citizens on the 55th anniversary of our independence. We have indeed come a long way. I extend warm greetings to you and to Nigerians in diaspora. My thoughts turn first towards heroes of our independence, martyrs who made supreme sacrifice for the freedom of our country, and great patriots whose relentless struggle liberated our motherland from the colonial rule. We have been masters of our destiny for nearly 6 decades. I cannot but appreciate and applaud those who made change of government possible in Nigeria. Most importantly, I salute the rare courage of the electorates and the electoral body. History and posterity won't forget your noble decision. I will also not forget to condole with families of those who lost their lives in the course of struggle for change. Nigerians will forever remember you. The emergence of President Muhammad Buhari won't have been possible without you. I will not fail to convey my special greetings to members of our armed forces, paramilitary forces, and internal security forces. Without such today, our territorial existence would have been eroded. There would have been no nation called Nigeria without your unparalleled patriotism and loyalty. I salute your courage and gallant efforts towards keeping Nigeria one indivisible nation. I will equally not fail to mention my leader, the president, the man determined to get Nigeria out of the wood, the apostle of zero tolerance for corruption, President Muhammadu Buhari, the executive president, Federal Republic of Nigeria. I sincerely extend my warmest greetings to Your Excellency on this 55th anniversary of our independence. As we celebrate, we also must give a thought to retrospection. Salient question should be asked, and that is, are we moving in the right direction? Our founding father's vision cannot be turned into reality if we spurn the very values that were compulsory to this noble cause, and that is sincerity of effort, honesty of purpose, and sacrifice for the larger good. We cannot afford to allow the labor of our heroes past to be wasted. Truly, we achieved independence, but have we attained freedom from greed, selfishness, and corruption? Our National Assembly look more like a combat arena rather than a fora that legislates. Our precious resources are being wasted through indolence and indifference. We need, as a matter of urgency, to correct this regression. We need a parliament that debates, discusses, and decides. We need a judiciary that gives justice without delay. We need leadership that is committed to the nation, transparent, truthful, and thorough in administering the state. Democracy breeds through a vibrant legislature, an independent judiciary, a responsible media, a vigilant civil society, and a bureaucracy committed to integrity and hard work. It survives through transparency and accountability. It's however very unfortunate that we have permitted unbridled personal enrichment, self-indulgence, intolerance, greed, and corruption to erode our work culture. Mahatma Gandhi once advised his people to avoid politics without principles, wealth without work, pleasure without conscience, knowledge without character, science without humanity, and worship without sacrifice. Institutions are a mirror of national character. Corruption has become a major challenge in our nation, Nigeria. I am, however, delighted that we have a leader who has zero tolerance for corruption. His emergence is indeed a blessing to Nigeria. All hands must be on deck to eliminate corruption in Nigeria. Unemployment must be collectively tackled. Terrorism must be excused. Let me conclude by saying that democracy and change of leadership have given us an opportunity to recreate another golden age. Let us not squander this extraordinary opportunity. The journey ahead calls for wisdom, courage, and determination. Fellow citizens, It's time to stand up for Nigeria. This is the clarion call. We cannot afford to heed the call for patriotic and personal service for our fatherland. Remember, life is not about duration but donation, not about acquisition but achievement. We shall be remembered by what we have done. Once again, I wish you happy celebration. Hooray! Nigerian is 55. God bless Nigeria. Long live the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Long live President Muhammadu Buhari. Long live APC Volunteers International. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful celebration. Thank you.